Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hello, this is Jacob Wilson recording an M15 draft for Channel Fireball. GP Salt Lake is coming up this weekend, and I'm doing a draft to prepare. This pack is quite strong. Hornet Nest is good, but I think Kurt Chieftain and Stab Wound are definitely better. In addition to these are the cards I'm only considering, but there are a lot of quality cards in the pack, like Netcaster, Spider, Coral Barrier, Covenant of Blood. So maybe I'll even wheel a good card. I'm going to take Stab Wound. It's one of the best cards in the set, as is Kurt Chieftain, but it requires you to commit to two colors, so I'll take Stab Wound. Okay, this pack, there are a couple good green cards. Elvish Mystic, probably one of the very best green cards, if not the best, and then Roaring Primadox. Alternatively, I could just take Sign and Blood and stick to black. I think that that is what I will do. Green-black is a deck I liked at the beginning of the format. I still sort of like it, but it's not my favorite. I think the best colors in the set are white and red, which I'm not really starting off in either of those because I'm in black. The typical black decks that I've drafted are black, blue, or black, green. But anyways, I'm going to stick with black. Okay, Child of Night is playable, but it's really not good like it used to be. I remember in M11, it was fantastic, but it's just not very good these days. There are a lot of mediocre cards in this pack. I'm just going to take another Sign and Blood. Alright, Satyr Wayfinder is a card that is so good in this format. It's terrific with Convoke, there's a lot of graveyard synergies, and it trades with cards like Child of Night or Resko Swiftclaw. So it looks like green could be open, potentially blue also. Even though Void Snare isn't good in a controlling deck, it is a okay card, so it might be a signal that blue is open. However, I'm just going to take Typhoid Rats. It's similar in power level to Wayfinder, and obviously it's much better because I'm only black so far. Okay, here's a Shaman of Spring, which is quite good. So it's looking... I haven't received very many strong signals, but the signals that I have received are that green is open, and hopefully black as well. Okay, now there's a few signals. There's Living Totem, which is great, and there's Inferno Fist, which is probably better than Living Totem, but not particularly good in this deck so far. Witch's Familiar is mediocre, so I feel like I should branch out into another color with this pick. Pillar of Light is also very good. Black-Red is not a deck that I love. In any format, it's never really very good. Although in this format there is Nightfire Giant. I'm going to take Living Totem because I have a lot of experience with green-black. Okay, Typhoid Rats does get worse in multiples. With a lot of cheap rats or removal spells and card advantage, I could see being on the draw with this deck, but on the other hand, Sign and Blood is terrible on the draw, unless you have a 1-draw. There's an Unmake the Graves, but I'm still just going to take a Typhoid Rats. It's not great, and I definitely don't want a 4th. Amphin Pathmage is another possibility that blue is open, but we're not there yet. Mind Rot. It's not particularly great, but I'll take it. Alright, Living Totem is a good sign that green is open. This card is very good. At first, I wasn't sure, it just looked like an average card. But with Convoke, it's basically a 3 mana 3/4. Even though it puts the counter on something else, you get 3 power and 4 toughness for 3 mana. Okay, I'll take Research Assistant. We might turn into blue black, though I'm leaning towards green black. I don't enjoy Verdant Haven, so it's possible that we'll board in Rogue's Gloves. Ooh, Shaman of Spring and Unmake the Graves. At this point, it's very clear to me that black green has a this archetype is completely open. I'll take the Shaman though. It's pretty easy to get and Unmake the Graves. Alright, so the first pack, even though our deck isn't particularly good, I'm very happy because it's clear that we're in the right colors, and moving forward it should get better. Okay, well this pack's not very good. Yeah, all the good cards are in blue and white, but at least I will get an Accursed Spirit. What the hell happened? What did I take? Okay, there it is, Accursed Spirit. Alright, there's another fantastic blue card, Illusory Angel. As far as cards for me go, Restock is very strong if I do end up getting Satyr Wayfinders and Necromancer Assistance and cards like that. I could potentially wheel Undergrowth Scavenger. And in all my black decks, I think Fester Gloom is fantastic. You're going to have a very hard time beating Tripulant Spirits unless you have this card. So I'm going to take Restock now because it's uncommon, but hopefully I'll get a Fester Gloom later in the draft. Yeah. At this point, I regret taking a Typhoid Rats over Satyr Wayfinder, but I think it was the right pick at the time. Okay, here's a Nightfire Giant that we could have, and we could have been in black-red, maybe. I can also maybe splash it if we get in Evolving Wilds or something. It's quite a powerful card, and Witch's Familiar is not very good. It's definitely playable in black decks, but once you pair with green, the green creatures are so much better that you never want to be playing Witch's Familiar. So I'll select Nightfire Giant. Alright, there are a lot of card advantage cards again, Sign of Blood and Shaman of Spring. We're sort of clogged in the 4-drop area. I also don't really want another Sign of Blood. I would consider taking Black Cat if I didn't have all these Typhoid Rats, so I'm just going to take another Shaman. Okay, Ulcerate is fantastic. At this point, with all the Sign and Bloods, I would definitely play a Child of Night, but I'm not going to take it over Ulcerate. Ulcerate is fantastic. Okay, this pick is interesting. There's Plummet, which is going to be necessary in this deck. This deck cannot be a flyer. There's also Endless Obedience, which is traditionally good in this archetype, but I don't really have any mill yet, so I'm going to take the Plummet. Okay, here's another Plummet, which I'm not even that sad about. Against a deck with a lot of flyers, I am going to want two Plummets. Ooh, Roaring Primordox is quite good. We have a bunch of 1-drops to return and these synergies. I would definitely play Carrion Crow in this deck, but and as I said, we're getting clogged in the 4-drop area, but let's be optimistic and call these Living Totems 3-drops, and my curve looks so much better already. Okay, Rune Clawbear. Something I've found after playing this format a lot is these combat tricks that look powerful, like Crowd Saver and Titanic Growth, are just not very good. Alright, definitely happy to get a Fester Gloom. Undergrowth Scavenger can be very powerful in green black decks, but I just haven't gotten any mill yet, and Fester Gloom is great, so Take that. Hunter's Ambush is a good sideboard card against Sanctified Charge and cards like that. Both these cards are pretty bad. I suppose that I will take Verdant Haven. Oh, Crippling Blight is fine. I might play that. I might not. At this point, there are a lot of cards in the playable section, but some of them are pretty loose. I probably won't main deck Plummet since I already have an Ulcerate and Stab Wound, so I'm not completely dead to a flyer. I would love to see Satyr Wayfinder and Netcaster Spider at this point. Alright, perfect. Satyr Wayfinder. A card that I'm quite happy to first pick. This card is just so good. It helps cast a Living Totem all by itself. It's great with Roaring Primordox and great with Restock. Like, not much more you can ask for in a card. Flesh to Dust, definitely the pick here. Alright, this pick is interesting. There's Necrogen Scudder and Flesh to Dust. Some people consider the Accursed Spirit to be better with Necrogen Scudder, which I couldn't disagree more with, but in this deck it's clear that Scudder is better because of my curve. So it's between Scudder and Flesh to Dust for me. I currently have three removal spells, and Flesh to Dust really isn't that great. It's definitely good, don't get me wrong, but it's no Doomblade. And Necrogen Scudder is a great threat and blocks flyers, which my deck desperately needs, so I'll take the Scudder. At this point, it's very unlikely that I play Nightfire Giant. My deck's pretty high quality, and there's no need to splash. Okay, this pick is interesting. I can play Child of Night. It's quite good with Living Totem. And to compensate for Ulcerate and Sign in Blood. Or I could take Necromancer's Assistant, which I have only synergy with Restock. I'm gonna take Child of Night. It seems great in this deck. Okay, this pick is quite interesting. There's Evolving Wilds, which would let me play the Nightfire Giant if I really wished. There's Child of Night, which is playable, and there's Ancient Silverback, so there's quite a choice for us. There are three compelling options. Okay, I'm gonna take the Evolving Wilds and play the Nightfire Giant. I'm not sure about this pick, but that's what my first instinct to do was. Alright, not gonna play Radiant Fountain in this two-color deck splashing a color, so I'll take Titanic Growth and probably not play it. Okay, here there's a Carrion Crow, a Meteorite, and Evolving Wilds. Crow is definitely good, and I have a couple Living Totems. If it were any worse, I would take Evolving Wilds, but I think Crow is just good enough that I'll take it. It improves my deck a decent amount. Ooh, Invasive Species. Almost mispronounced it there. It's good with one drop creatures, it's good with Satyr Wayfinder, Living Totem, and Shaman of Spring, obviously. So I will select that. Venom Sliver is just so unplayable in this deck when I have Typhoid Rats. I'll take Shadowclick Vampire. Cursed Spirit, welcome to the deck. At this point, I sort of wish that I took Evolving Wild since I end up getting a lot of playables, but I wasn't really counting on that. Anyways, this deck looks great. I don't have to play these silly Mind Rots. Okay, here we are for deck building. The way that I like to deck build is to take out all the cards that are close and then add them back rather than try to cut down to exactly 23, 22, 24. I like to get it down to like 19 or 20 and then add the last few cards. So I'm almost definitely not going to play Blood Host. Not Verdant Haven. Not Titanic Growth. I don't think I'm going to play Crippling Blight. This deck has little to no problem with a one drop. Though it is kind of cute with Invasive Species. Not going to play Black Cat. Okay, I have just enough flyers that I don't think I need to main deck Plummet, but perhaps I'm mistaken. Okay, I think I can cut Shadowcloak Vampire. My four drops are almost all better. I don't normally love Runeclaw Bear, but we have these living totems that we want to cast early. Fester Gloom is another card that I could cut. It's pretty great against a lot of cards, like any white deck, and it's fine against blue and red a lot of the time. I suppose that my deck may be high quality enough to only sideboard it. All the other cards are pretty great. Okay, so this is what the deck looks like with 17 lands. I could consider playing 16 because I have Satyr Wayfinder and Sign of Bloods, but there's a decent amount of beef in this deck, like Restock, Shaman of Springs, and Nightfire Giant. I don't think I'm gonna get too flooded. So against a white deck, I have a lot of sideboarding to do. I'll bring in Plummets, Fester Glooms, and maybe even Mind Rot, and I can cut some of these Typhoid Rats or something. But I think this deck looks pretty great. Pretty ideal. Sort by color. There's a lot more black than green. So I'll be playing one Mountain. The red's not really necessary for Nightfire Giant, it's still playable if you don't even have the Mountain. So one is plenty. And then I will play 9 swamps and 7 forests. And this looks. Oh. It's too many lands. Suppose I could play 8 swamps. That's really not as many as I'd like to play. I could play 7 forests. 6 forests, I mean. Alright, I'll just play 8 swamps. It's not ideal. And I'll submit this. I'll be back for round one.